PEGI 16.
Hello, this is Reed Livingston, producer for Falling Skies, the game. So today we're going to talk about enemies, and the first enemy that we have up is the mech. Okay. And mechs are bipedal robots that fight alongside another enemy called skitters. Mechs can shoot both bullets and rockets from their arms. They also use something that's called mech grenade, as you can see here. It's an RPG-like attack, creating an area of effect explosion in the target area, damaging multiple units if you are unlucky enough to keep them grouped together. They also use something called searchlight, which pinpoints an enemy, giving the mech and all allied units 10% extra chance to hit that unit for one turn. The next one we have up, of course, is the mega mech. Mega mech units are described as being bigger, faster, stronger, and scarier than normal mech units. They inherit most of their abilities and behaviors of the standard mechs, but they're capable of delivering and withstanding a lot more damage. They also perform something called shockwave, and it's when the mega mech performs a ground stomp and the shockwave that emanates has a chance to damage and intimidate enemy units. The next enemies we have up are called crawlies, and these are small spider-like creatures that attack in swarms. There's actually two types of crawlies. There's festering crawlies and regular crawlies. The festering crawlies have the ability to throw contaminant, which is a poison, at your squad members from a distance, as seen here. So the next enemy we have up here are called harnessed humans, and they are children which the Sveni has captured and fitted with the alien harness. They are the equivalent of the fighter class, and they have a limited set of fighters' equipment and abilities. In addition, they're the only enemy units that carry a med pack. They can heal themselves, or they can actually heal any of their allied units. Next up, we have skitters. These guys are very quick, very vicious. They close gaps very quickly. Of course, they can't fight with a gun or knife, but as you can see, their speed more than makes up for that. They also have the ability to move up and down walls without the use of ladders, allowing them to ambush and outmaneuver opponents.
Something hurts.
The next enemy we have up are called skitter commanders, and they're less common than the regular skitters, but they're higher in the pecking order and are capable of directly commanding their allies in battle. These are quite deadly adversaries, and they should be treated as a priority target by the player, who will want to shut them down very quickly. These guys are quite rare to see in battle, but when you do, it's quite surprising some of the things that they can throw at you. And that's about it for this episode of Enemies for Falling Skies, the game. Thanks for watching.